Hello, and welcome to a new series of mine called Tips, Tricks, and Guides with Foxy. In this first edition, I'll be showing how to get a very large amount of money incredibly quick in the game Gran Turismo 4 on the PS2. This guide is for those players out there who have literally just started playing the game. If by chance you have achieved enough progress in the game to the point where you don't want to start all over, that's perfectly fine. Look in the description or in an annotation on the screen for a time code for you guys to skip to. Before I move on, I must apologize in advance if my voice sounds a little bit odd in this video. I'm just now getting over a flu that I've had for about 2.5 weeks, so yeah. Alright, so let's get started. When you go into simulator mode, you'll notice that you have 10,000 credits. Do not buy a car yet. You'll want to save that money for later. What you want to do right away is go into the license mode and do all the challenges to get both your B and A license. Completing the B license with bronze trophies gets you the Volkswagen Lupo, and completing the A license the same way with bronze trophies gets you the Pontiac Sunfire. Doing these license challenges should take you less than an hour, but don't worry, once you do them, the hardest and most annoying part is over. So after that, what you want to do now is go to your garage and sell that Lupo you just won. Don't be afraid to sell it, you can purchase it from the manufacturer later on if you want. Don't sell the Pontiac because you won't get any credits for it, plus I don't think you can get it again. Okay, now you have a little bit more money to play with. From here, leave the garage and go into the map screen. Then head over to the used car lot number 1. You're going to want to look for a car that has a high horsepower, around 230, and obviously one that's in your price range. You have a couple options that could work, such as the Mitsubishi Lancer Evo 3, or even the Lancer Evo GSR. I went for the Subaru Impreza sedan. This left me with under 4,000 credits to play around with. I didn't want to spend all my money, so all I did was purchase the racing chip for that extra horsepower, and that was it. I did not buy anything else. Next, go into the beginner events and take part in the Sunday Cup races. It doesn't matter if you race yourself or choose B-Spec and have the computer race for you. Since you have a decently powerful car, the computer really shouldn't have any issues beating out all the other racers. Once you get first place in all 5 tracks, you'll get a small amount of money, however you'll also receive a bonus car, the Auto Bonacci. Go ahead and sell that car for an additional 8,000 credits and you should hopefully have enough to purchase another important upgrade to your car. And because I saved that 2,000 or so credits earlier, I was able to afford the second turbo upgrade, which shot up my horsepower to 325. If you're using a different car, you're gonna need to get that horsepower around 300 at least. Any less, and I don't think your car is gonna be fast enough for the next race. Okay, so now that you have your license and a car above 300 horsepower, you're ready for the next step. From the map screen, go to the Special Conditions events. Choose the second race titled Costa di Amalfi. Go ahead and take part in these two races, but be careful because if you hit the opponent's car or slam into the wall, you'll be penalized and forced to have a max speed of around 30 for 5 seconds. These races can be a little bit tricky due to the sharp corners, however, I've figured out a way to cheat the system. What you can do on most of the sharp turns, such as the ones I'm showing you right now, you can hug the wall and kind of slingshot yourself around the turns without braking or losing too much speed. This trick should make the two races much easier for you unless you're really, really good at racing games, which I admittedly am not. Once you win both races, you get a very nice and powerful Toyota RCS rally car. Even though this car is worth a lot of money, do not sell it. You're going to need it for the final part. With the money you just got from those races, go and get into your new Toyota and put some sports tires on it. I chose soft tires because it's just what I prefer, but you can pick whatever you want. Once you put those tires on, you're ready for the final race. At the map screen, head over to the Japanese events. Pick the first option called Japan Championship. Like with the Sunday Cup, you're allowed to have the computer race for you if you want. Because your car is so powerful, the computer is not gonna have any issues staying in first place. Once you win all 5 races and the championship, you get quite a good amount of prize money just from that alone. Plus, you get another very special prize car, the Nissan 350Z Concept. This car is worth much more than the Toyota you won earlier at almost 320,000 credits. With all that prize money, plus selling this Nissan, you're looking at roughly 400,000 credits. This isn't a one-time prize either. You can always replay the events as many times as you want and still win the same prize cars. So there you have it. That's my beginner's guide to gaining credits extremely quick. I hope it helped you all out. If you have any questions, feel free to ask, and I'll see you next time.